Hi, welcome to my playhouse, and today I'm gonna kick some more energy into this server. Right now this has two CPUs and they're both 2.4 GHz quad cores, and I just got a couple of other CPUs, and these are Xeon 5500 series, and these are the X5570, and they have a clock frequency of 2.93 GHz each of them. I'm gonna be putting two of those, there's one and there is two, so two of those into that server number two, which is the one that I'm playing with the graphics cards. So, but before I put the CPUs in the server, I would like to get kind of a benchmark of how fast it is right now, so that when I put in the new CPU, I can see how much I gain. So we're gonna go into the computer and do that, but make me happy and like the video. So let's go in and see what the server does right now.
Okay, here we have the server, it's right there, and the CPU inside, or the two CPUs inside, are quad cores, and the frequency is 2.4 GHz. I have this test machine on the server. Let's go into that. Oh, that's a small window. Let's make that bigger. There we are. We're gonna log in there. There we are. And we have the test results of this machine. How fast does it actually run? We can take the summary. The overall performance of this machine is 92.5. That's not a lot, because every other system in the world is almost quicker, but that's because this is a server and the 3D graphics is really, really horrible. It's right here, 7.7. So we're not gonna look at that very much. We're gonna see at the CPU benchmark. And this server, right now it scores a summary result of 7,650. And that's the number we're gonna try and beat, and hopefully that will work for us. There is other figures that the processor is doing. I'm just gonna be comparing with this number, 7,000. I'm gonna make a note of that. Now I'm gonna down the server and we're gonna change out the processors.
I just asked the server to shut down and it's just completed shutting down, so we're gonna go around the back.
Here.
Oh, it's a tight fit. And for those who follow my videos regularly, I have installed lamps. And of course, oh, now it's on. So it's a bit easier to see back here. So this is the server and we're just gonna disconnect it. There we are, and we're gonna put these somewhere where we can, like there. That's a good place. Right there. So now the server is free to go out. Taking off the case. And touching the case just to remove any anti-static. So, how much do I have to take apart to get in here? This is kind of in the way. I have to take some of it apart. This one is going away. Got the graphics cards as well. Put that over here. Plastic. So now I have direct access to the CPUs. I think you should have a view of that.
Okay, here are the CPUs.
And we're gonna take off coolers. And this one down here too. That's one. And the other one. They've been on there for a while. So now we can take out the processors, and I'm touching the server. The server is grounded to the rack, and the rack is grounded to ground. So when I do this, I am grounded with the server. Taking this one out. And we'll put it somewhere nice. I don't have anywhere nice. Over here. And taking this one out as well. And putting that over here. Then we will take the two new ones. They're in this bag. Oh, they're not in the bag though. And I'm gonna figure out how to put these in. There's a couple of tabs here. That one and that one. And I think that aligns with the couple of tabs on the processor. So let's see if that's not it. This looks very good. Those tabs out here goes with the cutout in the processor. So closing that, closing down this lever and putting it in under this one. Now that's in good condition. Take this bit away and do the other one. There is the same two tabs. They're in another. This processor has to point the other way, but like that. Close that down. Want to be totally some old cooling here. There we are. And I have some cooling pasta right here that I'm gonna be putting on the two processors for maximum cooling. Okay, I'm moving the graphics card out of the way again. That, this plastic bag does not belong there anymore. And there's a bunch of ways that you can put on this cooling pasta. I usually just give it a drip in the middle. Just a tiny little one. Oh. Okay, it didn't become that tiny. And look up. And before I go any further, I'm gonna remove the old stuff on the cooling fans. I now have a couple of pieces of tissue in my position, and we're gonna wipe this off. I'm gonna try and do it in front of the camera, but I'll try not to get this mess down into the server. Nice surface right there. And I have another piece of tissue for the other heat sink. It's So now we can put the heat sinks back on. And that goes, how does this go? There's a long tap here that goes into a long slot down there. And then this handle presses down the CPU cooler onto the CPU. And the same thing goes over here. There the slot is pointing the other way, so you might be able to see that. And that thing here goes down into that. So. So, that's it. Put the graphics card, oh, the plastic. Put the plastic covers back on. They help with the airflow. That's the way. Cool. Graphics card over here. And the last, this is just a PCI Razer card, and that goes right here. Cool, I think that was everything. Put the server bit back, move the camera. And we'll put the cover back on. Like that. And slide it back in. I'll go around back and connect the cables again. It's gonna be exciting to see how it recognizes the new processes, if it comes out and tells me about it, or if it just boots the operating system and tells me that. Okay, it did not complain at all. Focus. It did not complain at all. It's just booting ESXi 6.0. So let's see when it has booted that. So the server is still booting, but it has recognized both CPUs, X5570s, and those are 2.93 GHz. So we're gonna let it boot the rest of the way and see how fast it has become.
So here we are, and we can see here that the server has recognized that it has gotten new CPUs. It has the X5570, and those are 2.93 GHz each. Still two CPUs, 4 cores each, and 16 threads in all. So, yeah. Well, and I have turned on the computer again, and of course when the host changes CPUs, the virtual machine also changes CPUs, and it has recognized that it has gotten something new, some new CPUs. Don't know if it... Yeah, it requires a restart to really use that, so that's what we're gonna do. Restart. This virtual machine that I've built here, I've given it every CPU available, like 16 vCPUs, virtual CPUs. It has 6 GB of RAM, that should be enough. It has completed booting, and now we're gonna run the test program. See if that will run. It might be complaining. Yes, the license is out. Continue. Yes. And it's gathering information. We'll be right back when it's done with that. It has now gathered the information about the virtual machine here and showing us that we are getting 20 frames per second, which is actually a bit better than last time I did this test. But we are gonna run, I'm gonna run a total test of their entire system, and that will take a while, so I'll pause the video while that runs. Run, and yes. and I'll pause the video and be right back when it's completed. Okay, the computer now gets a result of 123.5. This is a very low number, but it's nevertheless quite impressively higher than before, where it was about 91, 92 something. And let's see what the processor is doing now. We are actually getting CPU mark, we're getting 9761 compared to... the improvement is 2101. So that's the extra power we get out of the system, and that's quite a percentage. This is actually an improvement of about 27% from changing out those two CPUs. In an old server like that, you get a fair amount of new power in the server by changing from the standard CPU to like one of the extreme ones, and the prices has gone down considerably. So that was a good test.
Well, so changing out those two CPUs in the server gave me about 27% more power in that machine. So if I just had CPUs for all the other machines, that would have been great, but I only acquired a couple of those CPUs. So, well, I hope you found this video useful. It's very easy to change out the CPUs. It was almost boring. Yeah, sometimes it's easy, sometimes it's a lot harder than you think it will be. Thank you for watching, and leave a comment in the comment sector down here. There's a lot of smart people that sees these videos. You might learn something. Thank you for watching my videos, do subscribe to my channel, and have a very nice day. Bye bye.